like everything was a party. Only 18 years deep and now we're getting started. Finish line clear, so we focused on the target. Wouldn't it be nice if we saturate the market? And wouldn't it be great if we could just simply rave and never think about calm down?
Hey, how's it going, everyone? This is Brendan Bias from GigiCheck.com and welcome to another HTML and CSS tutorial. So we've gone over a lot of the basics for HTML and how you can use it to build your websites. Now that you guys have those basics down, I think it's time for us to move on to something that will help you guys to create websites that are a little bit nicer looking and not to mention a little bit more functional. And we're going to be doing that with div tags and CSS. Oh yeah. Now, just so you guys know, CSS or cascading style sheets has so many aspects to it that it is literally impossible to go over every single thing that you need to know in one tutorial. So today we're just going to be going over a few of the basic ways that you can use CSS styling, and you know, we're just going to be going over some of those basic ways of using it. Now, I'm sure you guys are tired of me saying this, but if you enjoyed the tutorial, please give it a like. I really appreciate it when you guys do that. So if you guys could give this tutorial a like, I'd really appreciate it, but if you don't really feel like it, I understand. Okay, so what do you say we get into this week's tutorial? So let's open up the index.html file that we've been working on for the past couple of tutorials here. And I think the first thing that we should go over is what exactly a div tag is and what it does. So what do you say we get rid of this H4 tag here? I don't think we're going to be needing it anymore. And let's just type in a div tag with some text saying this is a div. So if we were to open up the live preview for this document, all you're going to see is the text, this is a div. You don't really see anything special going on here. So I'm going to use something called inline styling to help you guys see the div tag. So to do this, I'm going to type in the style tag. And now everything inside the style tag is actual CSS. So for example, we can do the background color, the colon, and what the color we want it to be. So let's do a light gray. And then whenever you're making a CSS style, you always end that style with a semicolon. So this is the style background color, then a colon, what you want that style to be, and then you end it with the semicolon. So right there we've got ourselves an actual CSS style for this particular div. Now if we go back to our live preview, you'll notice that we have this gray bar going all the way from the left hand to the right hand side. This entire thing is the div tag. A div tag is simply a container, and it's a container that spans the entire width of its parent element. Now, some of you might not understand what that means. So if I were to go to the parent here, in this case, it is the body. So we have the div tag inside of the body tag. So the body is considered its parent. And if I were to go to this body and give it its own style, and then background color, let's do like dark gray, I suppose. And then let's go back to our live preview. So now you should see that the entire page is now gray. That's because the body element is the entire page. And since the div tag is a child of the body, then that div tag is going to span that entire width. Now, if you look a little closer, there is a little bit of a gap on the left and right. And that is simply because the browser has a default style for the body here, which gives it a slight margin. So if you were to set a margin of 0 and go back, then you'll see that div tag go all the way from the left to the right. So let's see, moving on here, it's there's a couple of things that you should understand about div tags. For example, by default, div tags have no height. They have to have either something in it or to have a height value applied. So if we were to give this a height value of 40 pixels in CSS, then you could see the div. Another important factor about div tags is to know that they're called a block element. That means that div tags naturally do not sit next to one another. So if I were to do another div tag and put in some more text inside of it, if we were to go back, that text would be thrown down below our existing div tag rather than to the side of it. And this happens even if your previous div tag has a width value. So if I were to give this a width of like, let's do another 40 pixels here. Even though there's plenty of room to the right side of this div tag, since it's a block element, anything that comes after it is going to be put directly below it instead of next to it. Now, of course, this is something that we can change with some CSS styling. So if I were to have this element float to the left, then you'll start getting stuff to the side of it. But now we're starting to get some crazy stuff going on here. So let's just get rid of that float left. There you go. Okay, so you're kind of getting a somewhat idea of what a div tag is and how it works. But now I think the main question is, how is it useful? Well, usually div tags aren't really all that useful, if you ask me. It's only with CSS styling that they really become something very flexible and very powerful. But then again, that's what CSS is for, and it kind of helps with just about anything. So what do you say we start moving on to something a little bit more interesting as far as the world of CSS? So you've noticed that we're able to apply CSS inside a existing tag. That is called an inline style. And usually it's just one of those things that you only do if that is the only style you're going to be doing for that one thing in your entire website. Otherwise, you might want to consider doing a page style. So let's go into our head tag here and add a style tag. So now inside of this style here, we can apply CSS to anything on the page. So let's give you guys an example here. So you notice that we gave this body tag a style with a margin of 0. If we wanted to do this up in the head tag, we would type out body, which is the name of the tag. Then you do the left curly bracket, and let's go down and put in a right curly bracket. And now we can do our CSS styling inside of these curly braces. So we can do this margin of 0 with our semicolon. Now, just so you guys can actually see that the CSS is working, let's actually do another background color of dark gray, just so you guys can see that it's actually working. So there you go. We've got our background, or sorry, not our background, but our body tag being applied a background. There you go. And, you know, you can actually see that taking effect right here. All right. So how about we show you guys another little fun CSS trick here. So let's create ourselves a div tag, and we are going to give this a class called header. So this class here is sort of a unique identifier for the div. So if we were to go into our style, and if you type in dot header, and then let's also not forget our curly braces. So this dot attribute is an indicator for class. So if you notice, what we did before was just type in body. And that is something that you do for just a regular tag of any sort. So you could do a div, you could do a anchor, any tag that you can think of, you can simply type out, do the little curly braces, and start applying CSS to, and you'll see it show up inside your document. But if you want to do a specific element, you give it a class. So in this case, we do a dot header. So for this header, let's give it a width of 100%. So just to make sure that it's going to span across the entire document here, let's give it a height of, let's say, 260 pixels. And we'll give it a background color. And let's do F3, F5. There you go. And let's not forget the hashtag in front of it. So when you're applying a color for a background, you have to start off with the hashtag or number sign, and then either 3 or 6 digits to represent the color code. So this color is actually a very light blue color, almost white, but not quite there. And so if we were to go back real quick, you should see right now we have this header going across the entire top of our page. Now this is meant to be the area where we put all of our header content. So for example, let's take our image here and let's cut it and let's put it inside of our div. And so now that we've got this inside of our div and we go back, we should see the image now very nicely nested within our div tag. All right, so let's do something a little bit more interesting here. Let's get rid of some of this other stuff here. One thing that you'll notice is we have a bit of a hierarchy going on here. So we have the body to the div to an anchor tag to an image. All right. Now, this is something that you can actually use to define stuff in your CSS. So let me show you. If we were to type in body, a space, a div tag, space, an anchor tag, space, image, and then the curly braces. Now this is a style that is going to be applied to something inside the body, inside a div, inside an anchor tag, that is an image. It is a very specific call, and it's only going to work right here because this is the only instance in which that applies. So if we were to type in our width of 659 pixels and our height of 144 pixels. Now we could logically go get rid of these inline elements and delete those. And if we go back, should still look nice and pretty. Now, just to demonstrate that this is actually working, let's increase the width something crazy, and you should see the image being stretched. Pretty cool, right? That you can kind of do this bit of a nesting thing right here inside our CSS. Now, of course, it's kind of redundant to put body first since everything is inside the body by default. But something that could be still useful here is if we were to type in dot header and then anchor and then image. This will still work because we have our div class header, and then it still goes to the anchor and then to the image. So now we should still have our rightful image here. Okay, so let's move on to something that's CSS related, but it's another thing that you guys were asking about in the last tutorial, and that is how to go about centering this particular image into the middle of the page. And now that we have this inside of a div tag and we have that div tag being manipulated with CSS, this is actually really easy to do. So let's go to our dot header and let's simply apply a text-align colon center and end that with a semicolon. So normally what this does is it takes all of the text in the document, or sorry, not in the document, but inside of this particular tag, and it throws it in the center. Now, it says text align, but you know, it really applies to just about anything inside of here. So if we were to go back, you'd notice that our image is now centered inside of our document. Isn't that sweet? Right on. Now, one thing that I noticed here is that our image has no gap between the top of the document, and that's not something that I find all too appealing. So let's go to our .header a image and apply a new CSS style called margin. Now if you type in margin, you'll notice that there are a lot of ways to call margin. There's margin, margin bottom, margin left, margin right, and margin top. For the sake of simplicity, let's just stick with margin top, and we can give that a value of say 10 pixels, tab back, and see if we like it or not. Maybe I'll just give that a nice bump up to about 12 pixels, and we will call that good. All right, so we've gone over a lot of some very basic CSS styles, And right now they're inside our one document here. And now I think it's time that I showed you guys a much more widely used way of including CSS styles into a document. And that is by calling an external CSS style sheet. So let's go to File and choose New. And we're going to go File, Save As. And I created a folder for all of our style sheets. So I'll go in there. And I'm just going to call this style.css and save. So now we have our external style sheet. And we can go to our index and we'll take our existing CSS, cut it out, and let's also delete our style tag. And we'll just go throw this into our style.css. Now, let me select all this and do control plus the left bracket and then control plus the left bracket again to bring it off to the flush left-hand side of the page. Now, before we get out of our style.css, there's one little thing that I like to add into the style sheet here, and that is that character set that we talked about in one of our previous tutorials. So if we do at char set, and we do UTF-8, end the quote, and do a semicolon, now we can have our style.css have that character set of UTF-8, just like the rest of our website that I showed you guys with the meta tag. But anyway, so what do you say we move on and link our style.css into the index.html? And we are going to do this with the link tag. And so this is how the link tag is typed out. And in order to link a style sheet, we need to have the rel attribute. And we need to tell this that it's going to be a style sheet. And we're also going to do a type equals text slash CSS. So this is telling the document that we are going to be a style sheet that is going to be consisted of text and CSS. And now we're going to tell it where it is with the href. And we are going to do the dot dot slash style sheets slash style.css. So remember, the href is the same thing that we use for links. So this is a direct link to our style sheets folder to the style.css file. So if we tab back to our live preview, you should see that we're still getting all of the CSS that we applied earlier. Now, the reason that we do this is so that way when we create our new HTML documents later on in the rest of the series and whatnot, all you have to do is copy and paste this link file into the rest of the pages, and now all you have to do is edit this one style.css file, and now all of these elements are going to be cascaded across every single page that has the CSS file linked to it. And trust me when I say this, it's so incredibly handy that you don't have to go in and change the CSS styling for each individual page like you had to do once upon a time when, you know, before CSS was around to do that. But anyway, guys, I think we've covered enough stuff for one tutorial. This is getting a little bit long. Next time around, I think we'll start getting into how to go about creating a navigation bar for your websites and, you know, just continuing along with divs and how you can manipulate those with CSS and stuff like that. So again, if you guys enjoyed the tutorial, please give it a like, thumbs up, you know, share it with your friends, all that kind of stuff. And as always, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments section below. I'd be happy to help you guys out. And that's all I have for you guys for today. So I will see you next time. Peace. Man, I'm hungry.